Ascending above the clouds and the tree line to the actual summit, there lies the most magnificent view of your life. The vast and untamed equatorial wilderness. From high atop a permanent glacier, the crown of Africa. Getting there takes determination, grit, and a bit of luck.
Now this is the real medicine. This is what's going to get you to the top.
That's what I need.
Happily and safely.
Thank you.
Oh, boy, that's
the Tusker Juju.
Tusker Juju.
Yeah.
At 19,340 feet, the summit of Mount Kilimanjaro can be elusive. Some of the hardiest, most finely tuned athletes, even marathon runners, have failed to reach the top, while less conditioned trekkers have made it with relative ease.
Well done. Well done. What could you ask for?
What could you ask for more?
Little Frank, 77 years old.
I think I'm in pretty good shape for my age. I hope I can emulate my dad. You know, he taught me from an early age. I did the marathons with him. I did a few triathlons. And it's all because of him, because I just saw him doing it. He started. And I didn't realize this would be so emotional. I guess it's Africa that does this to you.
I would dream to be here with my son-in-laws and my son and my grandchildren. That would be fantastic.
Well, that's a compliment, Eddie.
I'm facing one of the most beautiful sights, looking straight at it, the peak of Kilimanjaro. It's been one of my dreams. And the fact that I can do it with my son to summit and together makes it all the more exciting.
It's gonna be fun at the top. Can't wait. And to see Dad up there.
They're breathing hard, but they're putting one foot in front of the other and showing good signs of early success.
Yeah, one more water.
Any person in reasonable shape who embraces the challenge has a chance to summit. A lot depends on your state of mind and how your body adapts to altitude, the big X factor on Kilimanjaro.
Breathing deeply, and we'll get to the summit. It's going to be painful. It's going to be the hardest thing you ever did. But I can't begin to describe the feeling you get when you reach the summit. And that's why I keep coming back, because I just love the contact high I get from you guys when I see you guys reach the summit up there. The hard part of these trips that are goal-oriented, like Kilimanjaro, for example, is that altitude plays an important factor in how well people do and, frankly, whether people summit or not. And that's certainly something we have no control over. We can try and mitigate some of the effects of altitude, but it all comes down to the last day and how people adapt. And the hard part is explaining to people when their bodies fail that it's not in their best interest to keep on going. It's a tough thing to do, to tell people that they can't continue on with their climb, but it does happen.
I take one bite at the bar.
When I was at 16,700 feet, my body wouldn't accept the oxygen. I mean, my oxygen intake stopped. He gave me a second crack at it, and Eddie, being the pro that he is, he says to me, your life is in my hands, gotta go down. And that was emotional. I didn't want to go down, I wanted to go up. And it took a little bit of to digest that that was as far as I was going. Not unhappy, I'm unhappy I couldn't make it to the top with Michael.
For Dad.
There are no sure bets. That is the challenge and the adventure.